Let's see. So I'm gonna take my White Wolf Guardian, my Shaman Stone, or Shaman Stone, depends. Of course I need my Gopher Bag, Archangels, and I'll take my Sandalwood. Okay. So grab a few things for protection. Okay, so here I have my Kiefer bags, and I made her a protection bag for put on her bed. Okay, too, just to check for a couple of things while we're there. And of course, my protection stuff I'm going to be wearing. And of course, my own gopher bag. Yeah. So I've got to go to a relaxing spot before I go there, just to chill and then talk over a couple of things, and then away we go. Yeah, it actually doesn't feel bad. But I do want to see something. See, it doesn't feel... feels a lot better in here. Obviously the shield's holding. Hey, Shelly.
This is holy water from the church. Okay, yep.
Right here.
Yep.
Right here.
Yep.
When you do your blessings, do a blessing right on the floor right here with the holy water.
Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah, I do this stuff too, right? My little business, yeah.
Again, so it's...
Because like I said, this, I wear everywhere, especially. So,
if thank you.
The candles.
Here's a piece of Bernice.
Okay.
Shelly?
Hi, Shelly. Yeah. This is Shelly for Thunder Bay Paranormal, everybody. So, make sure when you're doing your blessings to add the trickster, okay?
Yes.
That's why I need you to do the floor in that one spot. Okay. Because that's where he's hiding, underneath the floor. All right? They're not in your place, okay? The crawler and the watcher are not in the house.
No.
Okay, there's no human beings here, nothing, okay? What they've done is because they're so PO'd that the house is protected, they've asked a trickster to help them. Now, what a trickster will do is it'll throw its voice, it'll make you hear like it's right there.
Yeah.
But it's not. It can push energy, so... What it did, it's a real dick move, but basically what it did was it's in between the floor.
Sorry, honey. Really? Right?
Yeah. So it was pushing up
energy. Wow. Right.
Last night. You felt energy last night?
What's today? The other night. I went to the night before last. I went to bed and I could hear whispering and I could feel there was like something under my bed.
Yeah, that's just. The jerk off. He's just a jerk. He's nothing to worry about, okay?
Really.
But what they're doing, very uncomfortable, but see, that's the point.
I got out of there fast.
Yeah, that's the point. But we're not going to let that, you're not going to let that bother you no more, okay? Because all it is a trickster. And he's playing on your fears under the instruction of the ones that can't get in.
Right? Oh, okay.
Because if you become afraid, if you become that you don't believe you're safe, if you become that you're afraid of your house, it reopens the doors.
And they like that. And so they're going to work on me.
So they're trying to get you to be afraid so that your doors get open. Because they cannot. The stuff that she did.
So they cannot enter.
There is no way in hell they're coming in here. Okay.
Oh, thank goodness.
No way in hell. The big dogs.
Yeah.
They're out the door barking. That's all they can do. They come at the door and bark. Okay. Now, the trickster will also move stuff and throw stuff. So, yeah, the human spirit that you think was on your balcony wasn't a human at all. It was a trickster just moving shit because...
Oh, he was out there last night a few times.
Yeah, he does that because he knows you're afraid of it.
And it was about 11. And I like my curtains open sometimes just to... And then as soon as I heard him, I up and locked the door. Close my blinds.
Yeah, you don't
worry. In the daytime, it doesn't bother me.
Yeah, don't worry about it, okay? Because you can't... That just proves to you... Okay, stop and think about this. Right. He's outside.
Right. Which I'd rather proves, have him out there.
Which proves they can't come inside.
Right.
Right?
Yeah, he's so been hanging around for quite a while.
So by trying to scare you into thinking that they're inside, they just prove they can't come inside. Otherwise, why would he go on the balcony? I've walked around, I've checked everything. I do not see anything. There's nothing here. There's not even a human spirit in this place.
Well, I slept in my bed for two nights and I was looking, but I didn't see any, you know, shadows.
Well, as of right now, you're changing your whole attitude on it, okay?
Yeah.
Because you've got all the power now, okay?
Okay.
They are spiritual, so they can only go where they can attach themselves to.
Right.
Right? They can't attach themselves here because this place is now sealed. So if you're sitting on your chair and you happen to hear a noise, just say, piss off.
Mm-hmm.
Just like that.
I'll give you some later.
Okay, this is kefir dust, okay? Mm-hmm. We're just going to put it up there.
Okay.
Just leave it there, that's it.
I'll leave it.
Okay, and all that is, that's Holy Crossroads dirt and Holy Grave dirt, along with some other stuff.
Okay.
Okay? Any negative spirit that comes anywhere near it will get sucked into it and destroyed.
Oh, good.
Okay, this is like really heavy mojo, okay?
Okay, good.
So there is nothing. Now, there's nothing going to get in here anyway with all these blessings.
Right.
But anything that does automatically has no choice but to go into there and squash, okay?
That's it.
So we got to do that in four corners.
They'll get zapped.
They'll get zapped big time. So we got to do that in four corners. So you're going to place the last three, okay? Okay, now you want to put it up there, okay, and say, this is to protect my place.
This is to protect my place. Is that good?
That's it. Say ya. Hey ya, hey ya, hey ya. Hey ya, hey ya, hey ya. There you go. Okay, now let's go to the other two rooms.
Oh, please.
Okay, now you're taking the power, right? So you're taking this, and you're going to go to that far corner and say, this is my place, stay out.
I can put it on this little stand?
Put it wherever you feel, yep.
This is my place, stay out.
There you go. There you go, see, you're kicking the butt
forever.
Here. And forever, okay? And here you go.
Boss, you're
okay.
You're not scared.
Yes.
So now you're going to go and put that in that corner over there, and same thing, you're demanding that this is your house.
This is my place. Please get out.
There you go.
Stay out.
That a girl. Okay, and then I made you this special one. Okay, it's a stage 2 protection bike. Okay.
On my nightstand?
Yep, well, here, hold it first.
Mm-hmm.
And say, cleanse any negativity. Just hold it and feel it.
Okay, do I say that again?
Yeah, and you can hang it on that post there.
Cleanse any negativity.
There you go.
And perfect.
And bam, that's it.
Super, thank you, Dan.
You are very welcome.
Thank you. Come on, Miss Boobo. Oh, sorry. This is good.
Oh, yeah. How do you feel?
Good. I actually do feel good.
Okay, so you're never going to have anything negative in here again. There's no way in hell it's going to come in here.
No.
Okay? You've got all the protections. You've got
everything's been sealed.
Everything's sealed.
Blessed.
And as a backup, you've got kefir dust in the four corners of your house.
Right.
Okay.
Which is good.
You've got a stage 2 protection bike on your bed.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you took ownership of your house again. Okay. So this is finally your place and your place alone.
Yeah.
Okay.
Be able to sleep.
You're gonna go
not here, not there, here, there.
No. Nope. You're gonna go to bed and you're gonna go, oh my goodness, this is so nice, and you're gonna have a good sleep.
I'll just sunk right out.
Yeah, you're gonna be fine now. Job done. I feel really good about it. I feel very confident, very positive about it. A very, very solid cleansing. Shelly, you did exceptional work. Good job on you. Well done. Well done, Spud. You both did very well. We won't have to worry about coming back here again, that's for sure. So, blessings and light, everybody. I feel good now. Now I'm going to go relax, and we'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.